Joining us now is White House Principal Deputy Press Secretary Raj Shah. Good morning, Raj.
Good morning, Alisyn. Thanks for having me on.
It's a pleasure to have you. We appreciate you taking time out of your very busy day to be here. I have a million questions for you, so I will try to go quickly with our allotted time. What can you share with us about the revelations from the FBI report?
Well, let me just start by saying that the White House is precluded from outlining the details of an FBI supplemental background investigation or any background investigation. I just want to make that clear. That includes witness lists or the contents of the information. What we can say is that it began on Friday on the president's order and was sent over to the White House pretty late yesterday. 10 individuals were contacted. There was an initial list of four provided to us by the Senate. They were interviewed and then leads were followed up on. We feel very confident, without getting into the details, we feel very confident that when the senators have an opportunity to review this material, as they've already, they're just beginning to right now, that they're going to be comfortable voting to confirm Judge Kavanaugh.
Did the White House put limits on what the FBI could look into?
So just to be clear, and this is something that I think has been lost in the process, a background investigation is not, you know, an investigation, a criminal probe, for example. It doesn't seek to find a specific outcome. It seeks to find information for decision makers. The Senate has set a scope on what they are interested in. They've already investigated this matter through their own Senate process, through the Senate Judiciary Committee. They wanted interviews of additional individuals. Any background investigation has to have some form of limiting scope. And this time, it's always in these matters set by the White House, but we deferred to the Senate's requests.
Did you put limits on whether or not the FBI could look into Brett Kavanaugh's past drinking?
So to be clear, again, this man has gone through six FBI background investigations.
But now new information has come forward since then.
I would question the veracity of some of it, but let me be clear. He's gone through six FBI background investigations. Hundreds of people have been interviewed, members of his family, friends, neighbors, all of them get asked a standard battery of questions about suitability that includes questions about alcohol use, includes questions about, I don't know, potential gambling, fitness to serve, loyalty to their country. All these questions are covered. And to be clear also, a lot of people are coming forward with claims about his high school and college drinking, which the Senate hasn't asked us about. But also more importantly, you know, he has already admitted in his testimony that he drank in high school, drank in college, sometimes drank too much, drank underage. He said he likes beer.
Yeah.
I don't really know what folks who are demanding an open-ending fishing expedition into those areas want other than to delay.
No, they want to know about the memory lapses. The friends who have come forward said that they know that he had memory lapses and he said that he didn't. And that's relevant because Christine Blasey Ford has a story of him being staggeringly drunk and maybe he doesn't remember it.
Well, they're not actually claiming direct evidence of memory lapses. They're saying they don't necessarily believe his testimony.
No.
Let me just give you the real information.
They're saying they were his roommate in college. They knew him in high school. They were his drinking buddy.
You're talking about Jamie Roche's
interview,
right?
I'm talking about Chad Luddington, and I'm talking about a woman at Yale who drank with him all the time who says that they know that he had memory lapses because he couldn't remember the times that he spent with them.
Three individuals, I guess that you're referring to, have claims about what he said or didn't do while in college. That is not what the Senate is interested in or asking about. Again, he's gone through six FBI background investigations. All these types of questions get thoroughly investigated throughout one's career. He's been entrusted with some of the most important jobs in government over the last 25 years with a very high-profile career.
Yep.
And all the folks that are demanding this type of an investigation in the Senate are Democrats who've already pledged to vote no. They don't want additional information to make a decision. They want to delay this process.
Well, but they think that it would be helpful for the people who are on the fence to have all of the information. For instance,
why don't we ask the people who are actually on the fence, which the White House has been doing, what they are interested in,
and what
rather
has
than
Susan
allow
Collins
Democrats,
and Lisa Murkowski told you they're interested in.
They have asked about these specific allegations. They've interviewed, the White House authorized the FBI to interview certain individuals and then have follow-up interviews. They've interviewed, reached out to 10 individuals, comprehensively interviewed 9 of them, and that report has been sent to the Senate.
Debbie Ramirez is some of the new information. She's the person who says that Brett Kavanaugh exposed himself to her when she was at Yale. She says that she can provide 20 people who could supplement her claims, but that the FBI has not talked to them. Why not follow that thread? Why not try to get to the bottom of it?
So, again, I'm limited about what I can say about the investigation. What I can say is this, though. There is an individual who claims to be able to corroborate her story that has spoken extensively to The New Yorker. This individual says I can corroborate it, but he wasn't there. He has never spoken to Debbie Ramirez. He claims he heard the story secondhand. The New Yorker spoke to that individual who said, who supposedly told him he doesn't know about this story. I'm not going out on a limb when I say that's basically an example of hearsay, and that's not really worth the FBI's time.
You've seen more information than we have, which Debbie Ramirez
that's
says
all
that
in
she's
the New Yorker.
Given
that's
names
Alisyn,
to people.
That,
I understand.
What I just told you is all in the New Yorker. It's in their story. They freely admit it. This person claims to have corroboration. He's demanding to speak to the FBI, but he has no direct knowledge, has never spoken to Debbie Ramirez about this.
I think you're talking about the person who heard the story in real time, within 24 hours of it happening.
Well, he said within several days, he thinks. So, again, the FBI has trained professionals. We have not micromanaged their process. They did follow-up interviews with people who could have been, who could have seen firsthand accounts or be able to provide additional information.
Yep.
And they've come up with this supplemental report that has been now sent to the Senate.
Understood. So, Raj, listen, at best, it appears that Judge Kavanaugh misrepresented some of his past drinking to the Senate Judiciary Committee and some of his experiences in high school and college in terms of how
I would disagree with that contention, but sure.
Well,
I'll let you finish.
Okay. Yeah. So he, according to now many witnesses, he misrepresented the level to which he drank and his memory issues. At worst, he sexually assaulted someone, as Christine Blasey Ford accuses. Wouldn't it be easier at this point to go with a different nominee who doesn't have any of these problems? You have time before January. Just start over. This process has gotten too tainted. Start over and do a more clean process with a different nominee.
No, we're not going to do that. The president, the White House are firmly behind Brett Kavanaugh. We believe that all the Senate's questions have been addressed through this supplemental FBI investigation. And to be clear, allegation, we cannot live in a world where allegation alone can sully a man's reputation for life. Judge Kavanaugh has expressed his denial firmly, unequivocally, and repeatedly under oath. And Dr. Ford has identified three other individuals who would be able to corroborate her account, and none have been able to do so.
Okay.
All three have said they either have no recollection or don't think it happened.
Is it
and
your...
with respect to... No, you got to let me at least refute these points.
You got it.
Ms. Ramirez's account to The New Yorker only came about after she had a Democratic-connected attorney essentially work with her for 6 days to get her story in line with what she told The New Yorker. And The New York Times felt that that story essentially wasn't fit to print because they couldn't nail it down.
I think it's because Debbie Ramirez didn't talk to them and they wanted to
She had been talking to people just weeks ago, unsure about her account. Okay, so this is what we're dealing with.
I don't think
Brett
Kavanaugh's
reputation should be torn apart. I'm saying that when you come forward with a serious accusation like that, they are serious accusations.
Mm-hmm.
These things need to be investigated. The Senate offered her an opportunity to speak to them, to walk through the facts and provide additional information and evidence. She has chosen to speak to the FBI. She has. She provided them with some additional leads. Mm-hmm. I can't get into too much more information, but I can say that certain potential witnesses were followed up with.
Yep.
Nonetheless, what I will say is that the Senate, the White House didn't micromanage the FBI. The FBI has done what it does, the trained professionals, and we applaud them for doing their jobs in this background investigation. It's been sent to the Senate, no White House editing. And, they will be able to make a clear decision.
Last question, Raj. Are the votes there? Does Brett Kavanaugh become confirmed tomorrow?
Well, we think that some of the swing senators have asked for this set of information. They're going to review it, and then they're going to come forward with their decision. So we don't necessarily know yet. Obviously, the senators have just begun to review this information, but we feel very confident that we will have the votes.
Raj Shah, we appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Alisyn.
Very much.